that as Aokumushi walks up and puts a ward in the bot side river to spot out Steel when he does go for that. They should know bot leash, but they're going in for 2v2.
Quick lockup, Yumi coming out trying to body block as much as possible. Yudabon though is burning, has to be careful, the reload coming in. Yudabon flashing out of safety, ticking, ticking, and Yumi grabbing the first blood, cats out of the bag, and Gang might reach right into a body bag after a play like that. Has to run for the hills. He's got a flash, he's gonna hold it, he'll wait as long as possible, but
there. But now Owner and Carrier have paired up, Steel and Gang have paired up, that could be a 2v2.
Owner walking forward, stun now coming in, Steel got the level 6 as well, they're trying to lock in the town for as long as possible, but Yumi's bringing in a lot of healing, the Ignite as well, ticking against the Shadow Assault, bring the blades right back, and Steel now has to run for the hills, he's trying to put him to sleep, but it doesn't look like he's gonna have nearly enough damage. 2 for T1, Aria trying to make his way out. Owner very low. The Ezreal will take him down, but Aria just going to have to walk away from this one. Faker wants a kill too, but it looks like
Curtain Call
might have to be the final answer here. One last bullet, one more hitting. A little wide there, expecting the backstep, but will not predict it.
Yeah, you almost got the
your intended target, and doubly so when you're very rapidly falling behind in bullet. That said, you say Ludens. I say Kana's gonna run, and that was an oopsie. Steel now hopping her way in, prancing.
Close
he's getting dunked down. Is it enough? Owner on the way in. They might still be able to turn this. Kana might just be a killable. Steel, you're just too squishy. Oh, the Bambi flashbacks from MSI. They're coming in clutch. Kana's still gonna get taken down. Big Fist comes in from Evie, and Owner gonna make it at least 2 for 1.
You know, Gandalf beam where he has I have no memory rule, but you can see the power of Talon, right? The Owner just feels like he's at the right place at the right time. Yes, he's been full clearing, but he's found Steel multiple times on topside, and you can use process of elimination. Steel's topside. I pushed him out his topside. Faker.
Go. Aria getting scooped back. Talon does big damage. Shockwave good, but doesn't look like it's gonna be good enough. Aria's still walking though. The Soldier's gonna finish the job. Faker gonna grab another one. That's a 4.5k gold lead to 10 minutes.
And that's the punish on the missing flash, thanks to Gumiushi's roam earlier. The Jhin ult forced that out. They know they can get a kill, and now it's a smooth Herald transition right towards mid. And this game is quickly getting out of hand. They're already 4k up. Make it just about 5.
Yeah. And the thing is for T1, Owner especially is someone who I've kept my eye on a lot through tracking the pros. This guy is the highest ELO player in Solo Queue right now out of all bootcamp players in Worlds. He's almost like top 10, I think, on the ladder. And he has such good raw mechanics as he goes on to Steel.
We're now going in. Easy, fast kill pickup. Not going to see the Zenith Blade connect from Gang either. So that's it. He just walks out, walks in. Generally, when we look at how a lot of the smaller regions will take games off the bigger regions, it's usually through strong, aggressive, surprising early game. That said, that's where T1's strongest. So right now, things are looking very difficult. Evie gonna go for the dunk back, gonna pull in with the Haymaker as well. Faker looking a little bit low, but Evie now gonna be in trouble. Faker not afraid whatsoever, pushes him back, goes golden. He's playing for style points at this point.
Yeah, Faker just TP's top. Aria doesn't have it, he had to TP back to lane because he keeps getting ganked.
Leona's at like 80% health, and now TP coming in here from Evie. They're looking for another play.
Ana has to wait on the dash until Set goes for the pullback. Now trying to walk back into range of Carrier. He's got a big shield now coming in. Yumi all being used early there. He's going to find the triple snare now. Going golden here on the Lilia. Damage going to get flashed away from Evie. Now going to be in trouble. And again, T1 just turning this play right back in their favor. Evie can run, but he's not going to get anything done.
T1 is everywhere and anywhere. Faker's back in top lane. Carrier's roaming top. Gumayushi's running bot. Steel's dead.
Where did this cat come from? Just a lone cat just wandering up the river.
Whose cat is this?
Rihanna? Is that what you're
referring? The enemy jungler?
Yeah. Because that could be a problem.
Yeah. Generally, I don't think the games where the Yumi has as much gold as I do go well, I would say. Gang though running. Still very tanky. Talon doing a lot of flips. He looks very cool.
He's dead. Gang trying to get deep vision, but...
Yeah, that's it.
T1 kind of owned the map. That's probably like triple his damage right now, but maybe the play can come in from DMF, BFM. They don't have any TPs.
Can you see?
Nope.
Oh, Gang misstepped. You thought the cat attached to someone was the threat, but it's the solo cat you gotta be scared of. Gang running for the hills. The curtain call going a little bit wide, but the final shot is gonna connect.
At this point, really, the Jhin should attach to the Yumi.
Yeah.
There you go.
Double.
Yep.
That's what you expect. Now, 4C. DFM can hold on in this play. Gang still going for the aggressive engage here. On to Owner, but Owner just going to leap right back up to safety. Aria in the area. It's going to be a sleepy graze.
Oh,
manages to get over the wall. Big, big shadow assault. Oh, parkour. Here we go, baby. Assassin's Creed. Jump forward. Leap in. That's some Nakazian diplomacy. A triple kill for Owner.
Oh, I took the Quadra. No.
I was expecting the death cap, to be honest.
Well, Owner might be called.
Okay, a little bit of... Nothing gonna happen. Now it's the curtain call coming out. Boom, boom. Gumiushi doesn't even really get a chance to fire his ult as composition is already dead.
Well, Evie's got a kill, so he's got one kill more than everyone else. Take that, team.
Evie gonna step forward. Board drinker, maybe keep him up.
Oh,
no. Dies mid suplex. They wanted to get it, but it is not going to happen.
That's my favorite
emote. Teemo.
That's my favorite emote. The thumbs up from Teemo. Scout approved.
I don't think
you like
this
it more than just the classic tried and true regular thumbs up.
I like normal thumbs up first.
Scout approved is a banger.
Yeah. If this is the power of the scout's code, I'm sold. That's all I'm saying.
Well, that's going to be Mininip falling at 19 minutes in. Botanip's down. There's a wave coming in. T1 can move top as well. So DFM, they have to make some kind of play on this top Inip, because having 3 nips down at 19 minutes, it's all but done.
Yep. At this stage of the game, T1 beating them with their wallets. They can afford to eat all these skills and still probably survive. That's going to be the engage. That's
going to
be the shockwave. But there goes Owner to the back wave. There goes Faker with the double push. Evie now pulling back to the Haymaker. Just not going to do much at all. But they are going to grab one kill. One kill traded back.
Steal.
Finally getting his revenge. But T1 look to finally take this game. 19 minutes in. Absolute barn burner. They might struggle to end it here just due to the raw power of the towers. But with that timer so long, they should be able to close it.
Yeah, Gang standing in base. He's laughing on the camera. There's really not much you can do after the early stages. First 5 to 10 minutes when all the plays were shut down. It's desperation plays nonstop when the chances just keep slipping and slipping away from your hands. T1 with a statement game for their first game of World 2020.